Well, a very, very special reason.
Yeah, there's no respect out here. You know, when I came to the South from up north, I thought everybody was a gentleman and every lady was a lady. Well, I found out that that is not true. Look at here. No respect. You're looking at your champion, people. I am the Georgia State champion, and I still don't get no respect. They give me jeers, they give me boos, everything except what Ken Patera rightly deserves, and that is cheers.
Well, I understand, too, now that you have signed a world championship match.
You know, everybody knew that was just around the corner, including me. Dusty Rhodes, you haven't been champion that long. And I looked in the record book. Tommy Rich, another adversary of mine, was the shortest-lived champion of all time. Now, Dusty Rhodes, you're in line to become the number two shortest-lived heavyweight champion of all time. Because Ken Patera has you where he wants you, and that's in a corner. Dusty Rhodes, look at the body. Look at the physique.
Well, speaking of your body and your physique.
I am in shape. I have what it takes to beat the world champion and to become the new world champion along with the state of Georgia champion.
Well, Mr. Patera, I have been literally inundated with letters. One amazing feat of strength that you did, and that was blowing up a hot water bottle. And I have taken the liberty of getting one, and I'd like to have, so many people have asked for you to repeat that I would like to take this opportunity now. If you've got a moment, I'd like to have you redo that, if you would.
Well, Mr. Sully, you know, you have to prepare for these things. Every feat of strength that I do, I have to prepare mentally for. I already have the physical attributes, and you have to get yourself up mentally.
Well, I hate to put you on the spot, but I wonder if you'd mind.
Well, you have me on the spot.
Well, let me just open this up then, and if you...
You have to have protective goggles or protective eyewear, which I don't have with me. How do you propose? Should I just...
Well, I just blow it up like you've done it before. That's,
okay.
That's the thing that I would like to see you do.
You really got this all... I'll oblige you, Gordon, just because I feel that you are a gentleman and that you are worthy of my company.
Well, thank you very
much. I
don't
consider too many people worthy of Ken Patera's company. But the paraphernalia here, you can have that.
All right.
I'm going to do this. If I have an eye injury or something, Gordon... You know, like I mentioned earlier, I have an adversary running around here by the name of Wildfire Tommy Rich, he calls himself. Well, Tommy Rich, I saw you in the studio back there. Why don't you come out here and witness another feat of strength by the world's strongest man? As if you have the guts, I don't know. I know he's on the monitor somewhere around here.
And this is truly amazing, the way he is able to, the cardiovascular control that he has and the strength that he has in his entire system is really something to see.
Now, Gordon Stoley, you know, that just proved my whole point about Mr. Ken Patera. He ain't nothing but a big bag of hot air, just like I've been saying about you the whole time, Patera.
Well,
you know, Tommy Rich, it takes a lot of concentration to do these feats of strength, and I would appreciate you keep your big mouth shut. No bigger brain than you got, brother. You need all the concentration you can get.
Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Well, this is certainly not the place for something like this. Hold it. No, sir. No, just a second.
I'll tell you, Tommy Rich, you have been a thorn in my side.
This is not the place for this sort of thing now, gentlemen. Well, Tommy, please, I'm going to ask you...
I'll see you in the ring. There's a proper place to settle it, Tommy Rich.
Well, let's turn it over to our ring announcer, please. Let's turn it over to our ring announcer.
One fall with a 10-minute time limit, one fall 10. From Nashville, Tennessee at 205 pounds, here's Tommy Brown. Tommy Brown. His opponent, from Aspen, Colorado, at 235 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Lars Anderson. Lars Anderson. Your referee is Scrappy McGowan. We'll be back with this match after this brief timeout.
There's the bell. Lars Anderson moving out against Tommy Brown. One fall, 10-minute time limit. And Anderson very quickly unloads on this man, Brown. And Anderson has this extremely aggressive quality about him. He is constantly after his opponent. Uses a cross face lock very, very effectively. Uses those forearms effectively. Arm whips his man off. Caught him with a knee coming in. Notice the way he maintains control by keeping that arm. Gives him added force as he drives that knee to the midsection once again. Anderson, who's been wrestling throughout Western Alabama, returning here to Georgia Championship Wrestling, has Brown back to the canvas once again. And Anderson crashes down with that elbow. Anderson using that elbow on the back of the arm. Anderson smashing Brown's head into the canvas. Brown has not been able to move against Anderson at all. Anderson totally dominating the situation from the onset. And it is Anderson now hurdling Brown into the ropes and outside the ring under the concrete on the floor. And Anderson after him again, smashing him on the ring apron. Lars Anderson drives the knee into the chest of Brown, then using the flat of the foot into the pectoralis major muscles. Anderson bars the arm, drives into the one side to the... an inside arm bar. Anderson is, as he always has been, an extremely aggressive competitor, as I said earlier. Wings and locks the arm into the hammerlock position now. And Brown, facing a lot of pain here, as I said, has never been able to move effectively thus far in the match. He's going to have to get back to his feet and get that second burst of energy going if he's going to accomplish anything against Lars Anderson. Anderson, of course, out of the state of Minnesota, brings Brown back to his feet, traps that arm behind him, full body slam, and... Brown, barely able to move at this point in time. The flat of the foot by Anderson again on Brown, and Brown has not been able to move. He's being totally dominated by Lars Anderson. Catches him once again. And it is Brown conceding. Brown conceding, and Anderson pushing his man away in apparent absolute disgust, and obviously did not feel that this man was worthy of getting into the ring with him. I want to take a moment right now to talk to both Ted DiBiase and Tommy Rich. These two have proven to be quite a tag team combination.
Well, that's right, Gordon. You know, when you go through life, you know, my father told me a long time ago, you can count your best friends and friends that are going to stick by you on one hand. Well, Tommy Rich and I have formed that kind of friendship, and when get in the ring, we call it TNT. That's dynamite, Ted and Tommy.
Yes, sir. That's exactly right.
No question about that. And, of course, tomorrow night, you go up against Ken Patera in Columbus.
Yes, sir. You know, Gordon, I heard him out here talking about being humiliated. Mr. Ego himself, you know, he's on an ego trip, Gordon. That's his whole problem. He's got the muscles. He thinks he's got the pretty looks. But what he's lacking is respect. He don't respect the people out there. You know, and them's my people. He comes out and calls them rednecks and geeks. Hey, Tommy Rich, that's the background I'm from. I mean, that's my people. And that's them he's talking about. So we're going to take care of some business.
One more word about Columbus, Ohio, Gordon. Terry Gordy, I'm going to be there tomorrow night, and you better be ready for that.
And at the Omni, of course, on Sunday, July 19th. Quite a night indeed for both of you.
Yes, sir. You know, that's exactly right. We're going to start in Chattanooga. But just like you said, July the 19th, that's the big night. TNT, we're coming after Big Gordy and Mr. Snuka. You know, they're talking about how bad they are. We're going to find out how bad they are now.
You know, they're the Georgia Tag Team Champions now, Gordon. I'm not going to cry over spilled milk or talk about how they got those titles. I know that the people can probably figure that out on their own. But this is a new team right here.
Yes,
like I said,
sir.
TNT, that's dynamite.
Up against Tommy Wildfire Rich and Ted DiBiase at the point of time of the Australian tag team match, and it is DiBiase with a quick arm drag takedown. Timbs back on his feet. They circle. Collar and elbow once again in the center of the ring. Side headlock, but DiBiase reverses that to a top wrist lock to a takedown into an arm bar and an arm drag and twist. Makes the tag with Tommy Wildfire Rich, and Rich! Forearm, and this is the thing about Rich. He has that great explosive quality. Back leg trip by tag is made once again. DiBiase back in a lateral press after an elbow into the chin. Timbs makes the tag. The heavier of the two brothers moves out there now. And again, it's collar and elbow. Arm drag and twist reversal by Ted DiBiase. DiBiase makes the tag with Tommy Wildfire. It's a fire Timbs off the ropes. Rich catches him with an elbow coming off the ropes. Tommy Wildfire Rich now with a rear chin lock. Tommy Rich, of course, from the great state of Tennessee. DiBiase, who was born in Miami, Florida, but makes his home in Omaha. Drives a knee into the chest of Timbs. DiBiase catches him coming off the ropes. Whips him into the turnbuckle, brings it back, a snapmare, takes him to the canvas, then again drives the knee into the chest. A lateral press. Timbs again powers out before the count of three, and DiBiase tags up. Tommy Rich moves back into the ring. Whips Timbs off for a good flying dropkick by Tommy Wildfire Rich. And again the tag is made. Rich, of course, would like to regain, if he can, that Georgia heavyweight championship. And that's certainly understandable. Rich, good move. Dropped down low, swept the leg, and took Timbs off his feet. Brother started to come in to interfere. Rich caught him with a good solid right hand. A high knee that puts Timbs back to the canvas. And another snap there. I know that Mountain Mama and Chester over in Terre Haute enjoy watching Tommy Wildfire Rich in action. Tommy Rich, keeping the pressure on him now, makes the tag. Ted DiBiase moves back into the ring. DiBiase, good flying dropkick, caught Timbs coming off the ropes. Lateral press, but Timbs, again, moves away from that three count. Timbs now pulls DiBiase back and over, rips across the face. Could have DiBiase in trouble here. DiBiase, of course, serious neck injury a long period of time, but it is not affecting him any longer. He's back at 110%, but people automatically go for that. A front chancery now by Timbs. DiBiase powers him up into a souple. Beautiful move by DiBiase. DiBiase drives through. Under the blocking technique, tags up Tommy Wildfire Rich with two hard right hands, and it is Rich firing Timbs into the fire turnbuckle. Comes off the rope, catches him with a good, vicious right hand. Drives him into the knee of Ted DiBiase. Timbs back to the canvas once again. Quick double teaming here. Double elbows into the chest and jaw of Timbs. Snapmare, takes him back to the canvas, and Timbs tags up with his brother. And it's a beautiful flying drop kick now by Ted DiBiase. Off the ropes, Rich catches it in the pit of the stomach coming off the ropes. Again, the tag is made. DiBiase into the ring. Catches Timbs coming off. Power slam. Well executed. Spinning toe hold into the figure four, and it's all over. Tommy Rich catching the other Timbs brother coming in. DiBiase very quickly scoring. And a very, very effective move with a spinning toe hold from the power slam right to the figure four. And so the victors in this match, a great tag team combination. Tommy Wildfire, Rich, and Ted DiBiase.
Mulligan. And this is something to watch indeed. I can assure you of that. Something unusual happens here. There you see Blackjack Mulligan now putting the claw hold on Bruiser Brody. But watch things very, very carefully now. Watch extremely carefully the referee. And this, of course, Blackjack Mulligan is famous for. He has won countless matches using that claw hold to the head. And Brody is being driven back to the canvas. Both of these men over 300 pounds. Both of them 6'5 to 6'7. Extremely powerful. A battle of two complete giants here. And Brody battling his way back. Any average wrestler would have been out of it by now. But this, of course, was at the Omni on June 21st. Now watch as... look at Brody. Watch his hand. He's going into the boot. Watch his hand going into the boot. Unaware of this situation. Now watch carefully because Mulligan is set to go back to try and reapply that. Now watch Brody. I'm catching him. Now he had gone into that boot, taken something out. There was no question about it. Notice the way that hand is still clamped. Now covering the hand at count of three. But that must have been something very, very hard to catch Blackjack Mulligan like that.
All right, Brody, I'm going to tell you something right now. You name the rules, my friend. You got to take something out of your tights. You can't stand it. You got to take something out of your tights. You've always been a man like that, come from behind, hit somebody from behind. Right here in my hand, my friend, is the contract. It has been signed. Texas street fight rules, brother. That means there are no rules. Bring anything you want to, wear anything you want to, and Brody, I'm going to tell you something right now. You're going to need everything you got. You can bring the hog leg. You can bring your hammer. You can bring your nails. I'm going to have my boots. I'm going to have my spurs. Because, brother, here are the boots that for 2 years consecutively took me to the Texas Street Fight Championship in Sweetwater, Texas. And, Brody, you had better be as bad as you say you are because anything goes. You don't know what I'm going to have in my tights. You don't know what I'm going to have in my boots. Nobody has ever seen anything like this in the history of wrestling. Texas street fight rules, Brody. We're going to see how mean you are, how tough you are, because, brother, there's got to be somebody going down, somebody with some teeth knocked out, somebody hurt, and it's going to be you, Brody.
Well, some very strong words indeed from Blackjack Mulligan. I might just say that upcoming in another hour, we're going to...
Special attraction, a great tag team event coming up on Georgia Championship Wrestling. Introducing first from Oakland, California, at 265 pounds, here's Big George Wells. George Wells. His partner from Kansas City, Missouri, at 247 pounds, Bruce Reed. Bruce Reed. Their opponents, the new Georgia Tag Team Champions from Chattanooga, at 270 pounds, the former Freebird, Terry Gordy. Gordy. His partner from the Fiji Islands, Jimmy Superfly Snuka. We'll be back with this big event right after this.
There's the bell, and here's that special challenge match we've been talking about. George Wells and Bruce Reed going up against the Georgia Tag Team Champions, Jimmy Superfly Snuka and Terry Gordy. And it is Snuka out there now from the Fiji Islands against George Wells out of Oakland, California. And they lock up collar and elbow, and neither man able to gain any advantage at that one. You talk about four superbly conditioned athletes. You've got them in the ring right now. It's Patrick, the referee, watching him carefully. Side headlock. Wells fires him off. Snuka caught him with a shoulder and dropped him to canvas. Wells up and over his man. Catches Snuka coming off the ropes. Good arm drag takedown by Wells once again.
Snuka came out with sort of a right lead, and Wells took that one very, very quickly. Side headlock now by Wells. Off the ropes, got him with a good shoulder slam. Leapfrog that time, and Snuka tried to set him. Wells caught him in the forehead with a flat of the foot. Of a move by Wells, once again a takedown on Superfly Snuka. Bruce Reed moves in. Reed has Snuka to the canvas. Bruce Reed keeping the side headlock. Snuka makes the tag with Terry Gordy. Reed was unaware of that tag. And it's Gordy letting fly with a vicious right hand. Gordy, the kind of a man who would like to be an island unto himself. Reed with the leapfrog by Reed. Reed brings him up. Full body slam by Bruce Reed. Moving very effectively now. Makes the tag with Wells as he has Terry Gordy in a side headlock. Wells moves out. It's the side headlock. Gordy fires him off. And it was Gordy staggered backwards, but not off his feet, and again staggered backwards. Cross body block, beautifully executed by Wells. A near fall for George Wells. And so the Georgia Tag Team Champions finding themselves in a fight for their lives out here. Gordy lashed a foot to the midsection, now an elbow to the side of the head. Double teaming on Wells now as Superfly Snuka moves in. Wells taking a lot of punishment. Nick Patrick, seeing Bruce Reed, did not see the action over here. And that's a typical diversionary tactic by Terry Gordy or by Superfly Snuka. Snuka, boot to the midsection, a hard jolting right hand to the side of the jaw. Snapmare to the canvas on Wells, and it's Snuka closing in with a rear chin lock. You can hear them saying they don't need anybody. Teaming on Wells before the count. Snapmare to the canvas once again and into a rear chin lock. Terry Gordy. In a battle like this, it could go either way. There's certainly no question about that. It would be impossible to try and pick a winner in this match. Seems very evenly matched thus far. Double teaming again by Snuka and Gordy. As the tag was made, and Snuka back in the ring. Snuka. Chopping right hand. Wells, chop across the throat that time that straightened Wells up. Snapmare back to the canvas and once again back into a rear chin lock. Snuka and Gordy, I'm sure, as unpopular a pair of tag team champions as ever existed. Wells firing his midsection. Gordy, a cheap shot to the back. Gordy whips him off. Got him with an elbow coming in. It's Wells back to the canvas once again. Wells coming up rather slowly this time. Nuh-uh. Caught him in the midsection. Catches him again. Gordy rips across the face of George Wells. Now, Snuka and Gordy once again double teaming. Bruce Reed finally breaks loose, and as he does, Gordy and Snuka continue to take advantage in the corner.
Snuka to the canvas. Wells makes the tag with Bruce Reed. Bruce Reed over the top rope now catches him. We've got a fair sixer breaking out here. Bruce Reed explodes on Terry Gordy. Has him with a high, high back drop. Gordy in trouble. Snuka starts to charge the ring. Hits Bruce Reed up into the air with a beautiful flying drop kick. Hits Reed now using the elbow very effectively now. Arm whips Gordy off the rope. Catches him right at the belt line. Coming off the rope, Bruce Reed closes in again. Gordy again rips across the face of Reed. Shielding right hand to put Reed back to the canvas. Reed powers out before the count of three. The tag is made with Snuka. Now it's Snuka against Reed. There again is that exceptionally fast foot of Superfly Snuka. Again, the tag is made. And they catch Reed in the rib cage in the side of the jaw and across the back before the count, and it is Gordy now driving a hard right hand. Bruce Reed fires back to the midsection. Again, Gordy rips across the face. And now they're double teaming, and the referee with the count. And repeated counts by the referee. And they continue the double teaming. Now the tag is made. Once again, a boot to the rib cage, a hard jolting blow to the side of the head. Bruce Reed trying to battle his way out of that corner if he can, a knee lift. Again, the tag is made. Snuka and Gordy tagging out very, very effectively. Snuka catching Bruce Reed, drops into the canvas. Bruce Reed fires to the midsection. Snuka makes the tag. Terry Gordy moves into the ring. And again, they're double teaming. They continue double teaming on Reed. Wells finally can stand it no longer, charges out, catches Snuka. And it's Terry Gordy. Look at this as Snuka up on that top rope crashes down across Bruce Reed. And the referee trying to restore order here. And the referee telling him, no deal, no deal. And so, Nick Patrick doing an outstanding job of officiating. Nick Patrick doing an outstanding job of officiating there as Snuka and Gordy continue to double team. The referee finally firing of those tactics has disqualified the Georgia Tag Team Champions for their two-on-one series. And so the victors in this match via disqualification, George Wells and Bruce Reed, and apparently this makes little or no difference to the Georgia Tag Team Champions nonetheless. But
what's going on? You know, I believe last week we were standing out here and we were
all right. Our time is gone.
Hey, baby, wait
until next week.
I had to talk to